In this lecture, we'll cover the difference in the behavior between the electric and the magnetic dipole. Let us first take the electric dipole. These are two charges, positive and negative, and we know for dipole, we show the direction of dipole from minus to plus. If you have a dipole here, small distance, L, twice L if you take, then the direction of dipole is shown always from negative to positive, and the electric field which will emerge will be like this. Starting from positive and going to negative. Now let us see how in the expanded diagram. So this is the direction of the electric field. See, this is the direction of the electric dipole is shown from negative to positive, and these are the electric field lines. You look at the direction of the electric field at the center of the dipole, and it is downwards, so it is like this. So at the center of the electric dipole, the electric field lines are in opposite direction to the direction of the dipole. Both E and P, they have opposite direction at the center of the electric dipole. Now let us consider the case of a magnetic dipole. The behavior is completely different. And if this is a coil having current in this direction, then the magnetic field produced by it would be like this. These are the magnetic field lines, and this is the dipole. If the current is in this direction, we know by the right hand thumb rule, this is the direction of the magnetic dipole. And what is the direction of the magnetic field inside the dipole? It is same direction. The direction of electric field in the center or inside the dipole is same. So both the B and the mu are in same direction. And it is just the opposite as compared to the direction of the electric field and the electric dipole at the center of the dipole. Now this difference is the reason why we have different behavior, like when you place a paramagnetic material inside a magnetic field, the magnetic field line gets concentrated. If the magnetic field lines are going like this, you are having this magnetic field lines. This is North Pole. This is the magnetic field line. Suppose you place some material here. It will get magnetized. Of course, the material has to be paramagnetic and not the diamagnetic. It gets magnetized. South Pole will be here. And it will have its own magnetic field lines. And magnetic field lines inside this will be in the same direction as the magnetic field lines which magnetized this material. So this has resulted in concentration of magnetic field lines in this region. So you are producing a higher magnetic field. Unlike the case where you place a dielectric material in the electric field, you place a dielectric, this be positive, this be negative, these are the two plates of the capacitor, and let us place a dielectric. This will be negative, the surface, and this surface will be positive, and the electric field is E0 in absence of the dielectric in this space. Now, when there is dielectric, there is electric field from positive to negative inside the dielectric, which is EP. So, the resultant electric field would be vector E0 plus vector EP. These are vector quantities, and direction of EP is just reverse opposite of E0. So, it is E0 minus EP. And we can see the electric field inside that, in that space where dielectric has been placed, gets reduced, which does not happen in case of the magnetization or the magnetic material. Thank you.